This ELISA tutorial series is kindly sponsored by CalBiotech. Please click the link below or in the video description to see what ELISA kits they have to offer. Today we are going to discuss how a competitive ELISA works. Just like any other ELISA, the goal of a competitive ELISA is to measure the amount of a specific protein, metabolite, or antibody that is present in a given sample. Although the steps and reagents involved with competitive ELISAs can vary, having a solid understanding of some basic concepts will be useful for anyone who wants to be familiar with this very important technique. In order to know how a competitive ELISA works, we have to remember a few key terms. Antibodies. Antibodies are a special type of protein which are normally produced by our immune system in order to protect us from harmful organisms like bacteria and viruses. Antibodies are special and extremely useful because they have the ability to recognize specific shapes and then bind very tightly to those shapes. In ELISAs, antibodies are selected based on their ability to bind to the substance that we would like to measure, such as a protein of interest. Enzymes. Enzymes are proteins that allow a chemical reaction to occur very easily. The enzymes most commonly used in ELISAs, such as HRP, convert a clear reagent known as a TMB substrate to a blue-colored product which can be easily measured. It's important to know that enzymes can be connected or conjugated to other proteins and antibodies. Whenever you hear the term enzyme conjugated, such as a enzyme conjugated protein or an enzyme conjugated antibody, that simply means that the enzyme which produces a color change has been attached to a protein or an antibody. Now that we are all on the same page, let's go over how a competitive ELISA actually works. As with all ELISAs, the action really starts in the wells of a special type of 96-well plate, which is known as an ELISA plate. ELISA plates are designed so that they can bind proteins with a very high affinity. For this reason, it's not recommended to attempt an ELISA with other types of 96-well plates, such as tissue culture plates. If you've seen our previous videos on how direct, indirect, and sandwich ELISAs work, you'll remember that in all three of these techniques, the antibodies, samples, and reagents are added to the ELISA plate separately and in a sequence, that is, one after the other. Competitive ELISAs are unique because they always involve a step where the samples are first mixed together with another reagent before or while they are added to the ELISA plate. Competitive ELISAs may vary from one another depending on what exactly gets mixed with the samples and when they are mixed, but the idea remains the same in that something in the sample will always compete with something that gets mixed with it, hence the term competitive ELISA. Let's look at an example of how this might work. Imagine that we have some samples that contain a mixture of different proteins, and we want to measure the amount of a specific protein, like the one shown here in green. First, we will coat the bottom of an ELISA plate with an antibody that specifically binds to our protein of interest. After coating the ELISA plate with antibodies, we will block the plate in order to prevent any non-specific binding of proteins to the ELISA plate. If this concept is unclear, please review our previous ELISA tutorial videos. Now that the ELISA plate has been coated with antibodies and blocked, we will begin the competitive part of the competitive ELISA. We will now mix our sample with a solution containing an enzyme-conjugated version of our protein of interest. As we mentioned earlier, enzyme-conjugated means that our protein of interest has been attached to an enzyme that will produce a color change later on in the assay. From now on, we will simply refer to the enzyme-conjugated protein of interest as the enzyme conjugate. Once our samples have been mixed with the enzyme conjugate, we will add the mixture to the ELISA plate. Here is where the protein of interest that was in our sample, indicated here with arrows, will compete with the enzyme-conjugated proteins that we added to the mixture, as they both will try to bind to the limited number of antibodies on the ELISA plate. After the mixture has had enough time to bind, The next step will be to wash away any unbound protein and enzyme conjugate from the ELISA plate. Then a colorless chemical substrate, such as TMB, will be added and incubated with the samples for a few minutes. The enzymes on any enzyme conjugates that manage to bind to the antibodies will produce a color, shown here as blue, from the originally colorless TMB substrate. The more enzyme conjugates that are present, the more the color will be produced. After a few minutes, a strong acid, usually known as stop solution, is added to the ELISA plate, causing the color-producing reaction to stop, and also causing a color change from blue to yellow. The amount of yellow color in each well of the ELISA plate can then be measured in a plate reader and used to determine how much of our protein of interest was in a particular sample. Let's take a minute to explain how this works. You can imagine that if the amount of protein of interest in our sample is much higher than the enzyme conjugate, then the protein of interest in our samples will bind to the majority of the antibodies based simply on chance. The opposite will be true if the amount of protein of interest in our sample is much lower than the amount of enzyme conjugate. In this case, the odds will be in favor of the enzyme conjugate, resulting in them binding to most of the antibodies on the ELISA plate. It's important to note that competitive ELISAs are different from direct, indirect, and sandwich ELISAs in that the amount of color change produced is inversely related to the amount of protein of interest in the sample. In other words, samples with a high concentration of the protein of interest will produce less color change, because very little enzyme conjugate will be able to bind to the ELISA plate. And the opposite is true. Samples with very little protein of interest will produce a lot of color, because a lot of the enzyme conjugate will be able to bind to the ELISA plate. In the following videos, we will illustrate the actual steps of a typical competitive ELISA kit and explain how to interpret the data that can be obtained using this technique. If this tutorial was helpful, please click the like button below. You can also subscribe to our channel for updates when new videos are released. Thanks for watching.